See if he leaves a blue for the rest of the game. Interesting. I think this guy should probably have mulliganed some of these hands, personally. These hands have not seemed particularly good. Sure. I think I blow up Glimmer Post, because I don't want him to get any, like, shenanigans with playing a tapped Cloud Post and untapping it. So I think I just keep him off of it. Plus, it just makes our Spell Pierce better. The real question is, what do I do? Do I pump the Frostborn Warrior and put him on a three-turn clock? Do I Ponder? Do I Spell Pierce? I think I just pass. Okay. I don't know, maybe he just wants to block or something, I don't know. I guess we want like this. I should have pumped, but now I will from this point on. Guess I Spell Pierce this. Do I attack with the Delver? I think I do. I think I'm okay trading. No? Yeah, okay. That's a good point. I can. He just will pay it. But I can daze it too. And I'll do that. That's pretty aggressive. Yeah, it might be game, but I enjoy making them use all of their clock because, not really because I even intend to clock them out, but mostly because I just feel like it makes them play worse. Showing a mold drifter, I assume. And a glimmer post. Obviously not that great for me because you can always figure it off and then whatever, but I think he needs another cloud post to really get me good in a time-efficient manner, I should say. Okay, or that. I did make a few mistakes in this game, so I have to bounce back next game. So. Actually, I'm gonna attack first. I assume Hydro Blast. Oh yeah, little victory. card always has so many more time counters than I feel like it should. What do you think? Do I? I think I just go. I think he's going to double block, and then I'll bolt one. And then maybe he's got the Hydro Blast, but I think this is going to take him a long time to win. The reason why I kind of don't think he has the Hydro Blast is, one, I think he would have countered the raise. And two, it's actually better to block and do that. But in the course of this game, I've killed a lot of his actual threats. Like, I guess he still has Crusher available to him. And this is infinite mana, but still going to take him a while, I think. And he doesn't seem very good. It's pretty amazing how often people get infinite mana with this deck. It's just like mind-blowing. Because it's like, it's honestly like a five-card combo. You need to get the wall, the cloud, a flicker, the cloud post, and a glimmer post, or maybe two cloud posts. But a cloud post and another post. Like, that is nuts. And that's just infinite mana. Okay, you can have the serrated arrows that does ground nothing. Oh, I guess you can bounce my cloud. You can play your crusher. Oh. Well, I guess this is kind of interesting, because unless, well, no, it's not, because he could always just return Fissure twice in a turn with infinite mana, get Mind Delver that way, but apparently he doesn't want to do it like that. He'd much rather just Serrated Arrows my guy. This is what, like, technically infinite life, infinite mana, infinite everything. Infinite draw. Arrow counters, yeah. Pretty obnoxious. I don't know. It's the first multi-queuing of the night. Well, he can go about his business. I'm really unimpressed with Aaron's Ephemeron. I think it is our best, like, third option, but I'm never happy with it. It just takes, like, one turn longer than it should, and its X4s are really not that good in this format. Fine. be okay with a lot of things, as long as this isn't... I don't really care what this card is. I'll probably be happy with anything. Besides an island. One island would be the worst. It's actually also not that great. I think I'd rather... I think I'd rather just have this. Frostburn Ward's better with my mana. But... yeah, this just seems like it's going to flip at the same time, so. This is Dazed, the other one. Wow, and Autog. Did I just lose? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, pretty much. Okay, well, I guess I have to bolt a Disciple. And 11 maybe. Are you kidding me? So if he just like cracks this, draws an artifact he can play, I lose. Okay, cool. Wow, this game would be like, because he's playing so poorly, conceivably we could win this if I drew anything but lands over the last, like, four turns. If his goal is to Cloud of Fairies me to death, I think he's going to run out of time fairly quickly. Sure, you got it. I find bolts aren't very good in this matchup. So underwhelmed with you. I think a day's out. These is not very pro. Actually, I'll take a couple off. They're not very good in this matchup. There you go, he finally figured it out. I think we lost that last game because our Delvers didn't flip. Like, they just took too long to. It's kind of bad luck. And also his luck sackery. Like, I'm generally underwhelmed with Disciple. Hey. Great day's target. Bolt. Of course we're going to land. I think here we leave up Hydroblast because there's a good chance he'll have another one. I've thought about that. In fact, actually, the first version of this list had Kilnfiend. The thing is, they just sit there. Like, but it's worth a shot. I mean, I think I'd go back to it. Sure, you can frog. Guess you can frog twice. You have a force or two. Just, oh no, okay, I can handle that. Because I honestly feel like this deck is just like one cheap, efficient creature away from being like super good. Interesting. I guess that makes sense. He's sort of winning the race. Five. He's not. This guy's got nine cards left. In 5 minutes on the clock, roughly. If we don't have like one of those just draw crap hands and have to mulligan to oblivion, I think we'll be okay. We just leave that mana leak. I guess land Gale Blast beats us. Or guy Gale Blast. So if I counter this, we just win, I think. No, I'm an idiot. No, we don't. Oh, whew. Well, I guess I had to counter that. Otherwise, we would have. Well, okay. That was actually fine. Oh shoot, I thought this game was already over. I don't know what I want. Probably Stone Rain on the play is what I want for sure. Stealth Suit, I don't think we want. What? Where did my cards go? Doomblade on a Delver. I assume he gets in. For four. Okay. Delver. Yeah, we smash too. Think that does less damage to us. Yeah, it does by two. Sounds pretty good. Huh. I think. Jeez. I think ultimately I'm gonna want the Gush and Stone Rain. Maybe not the Stone Rain. Play a land, I suppose. Prof Prism too? No. Wow, this is tricky. I think I'd just go like this. Oops. I meant to pump. Okay. Figures, but I don't really know what I could do differently there. Could raise, but then we'll never stone rain. Raise and four. Yeah, I used to love me some figure posts. Now it's the number one enemy. That was a weird attack. Especially because he has prop prism. So I think here, jeez. Okay, gosh, is what I do. So I think you might have dispel. Nope. Oh wow, I'm running low on time too. That is a good way to win in a hurry. don't know who this guy is. I don't know what's more important here. I think... Seems like a dick. He's doing this. I think I chumped this turn. Because of this exact situation. I guess he could fissure me though. It'd be annoying. This is game three. That's a bummer. I was going to time him out. That early crusher, I think there was like, that was pretty much the only way I could possibly lose, was like that or like a really bad mulligan. I believe this is the last round of it all. That's really a bummer, because I feel like that matchup's really good for us. I just feel like... I actually kind of feel like I messed up. Yeah, it was a dick move, but the even bigger thing was, like, why me, you know? Like, I don't know this guy. Maybe he's friends with the other guy. And it didn't impact anything. If anything, it just made him take longer to get to his next match by distracting me. I do think I misplayed. I am pretty confident on the early turns I misplayed. Like, I should have probably raised something. I think turn two I should have, like, Delver raised, but I just, like, chickened out. Because I was like, what if I never draw another land? What if I never draw another land? But I think if... Because that's, like, what I was afraid of, right? It was just, like, mulliganing into Oblivion. But... I think that would have slowed him down enough to time him out at a minimum, so. His hand seems fine. Maybe we'll beat Affinity this time. I still don't know what I think about this matchup, in all honesty, but I personally think that he, the last guy, just had some nuts draws. Really? Another one? Well, that did not work well. Yeah, is it aggressive? Because I found that like aggressive popper decks are. That's interesting, no attack. Jeez, what do I do here? Like I could get so far behind if I don't blow up a land. But also, I'll never win if I don't cast the Ephemerons. I'll just suspend one. Yeah, I don't need to suspend both. So I think he has another Gjalp Blast. That's the only reason I can think of for not attacking with that. Oh man, really? Another pot? Oh, maybe not. That's annoying. Dang, he did have it. Yeah, these guys have to come out. These are just too. They just do nothing. They just do nothing. Yeah, there's got to be something else we can do that's not Legionnaires or Ephemeron. Because they are just Yeah, I don't think that like Ephemeron like does anything ever. Like the times I feel like it's, yeah, the times I feel like it's won have been times in which it's like I'm playing something really weird, playing against like a really bizarre opponent who's playing like Squadron Hawks and stuff. I think a lot of people will mulligan this. I'm not going to. I could just immediately lose. But whatever. Yeah, Martyr of Ashes is pretty good. I also really like the Scent of Cinder, which is a card like that. I've often thought Scent of Cinder should maybe get played a little more than it does. All right. Clout. Oh my God, that actually worked. Wow. Nothing. I think Frogmite's coming next turn, and it is super dead. Yeah, maybe not. Maybe not now that there's. Yeah. Whatever we put in has to be good with clout. Like this card, I think I'm gonna, I don't know, like I like this the stealth suit against the like the one matchup I really find. Really want another. The matchup I really want another clout in. Right. 1-1. Splitsies. Got there with a really funky hand. This deck is just so high variance. Like, the highest I've ever played. I wonder if I want a weather seed. I think I do instead of a stone rain on the draw. Just without any ephemerons, I need some way to beat down that's not going to immediately die to a bolt. Or Gelf Blast. Well, I definitely want that, but do I want the mana chains? I don't know if I need to. I don't really know how good they are, so. Oh, remove all yield. How do I want to do this? I don't think I do, actually. Yeah, that was sweet. Alright, I'll daze that. Do nothing about that. I wonder if he thinks he can Gale Blast me. I bet he does. Or do I just lose? I don't think I do. Oh, maybe he's not very good at flinging. Think bolt it? Yeah, I'll bolt it. Yeah, it seems good. I mean, this seems like a really good tempo play. It's basically like a 1 mana stone ring. So does this kill me? No, because I have counter magic. Actually, yeah. Hmm.
Maybe I shouldn't have done it like that. Actually, that was really bad. Because I could have just killed... Oh, wait. That does it for me. Well, my misplay trades with his misplay, I guess. Yeah, I should have just done that way differently. Would I block? Like, maybe? Six, seven. I don't think I would. There were... Oh, shoot! Keep clicking through that. I'm playing poorly. Alright, do I take this? I don't think I do. I think I just... I do, actually. I think the odds of him getting Gal Blast there are pretty insane. Like, so insane that I'm willing to take the risk. That was sweet. No, he didn't. He just drew it that turn. So, like, he would have had to have just, like, randomly drawn into it. Do I blow up a land or the Springleaf Drum? I think... I'm fine with making him... Sure. Now I see no reason to attack with Frostburn Weird again. Because I would just lose. To attack? Oh no, that'd be so bold. Oh man, do you think he's going to attack me? No. Whew. Please, something I can do. Yes. So he has to attack with Atag here, right? So I have to stay back. Okay. So if I attack with both, he blocks here and here, right? Because like he's got to have like a removal spell for this, or he just loses. So I should probably attack both. If I do, 2, well, he can pay this next turn, so maybe it's not that good to attack both, because he just chumps, kills, I lose, so I won't do that. I think if he had blast, we just lose. So this would have to be like a pyroblast or something. Hydroblast? Pyroblast? Doomblade? So I just pass. My brain hurts. Yeah. Oh man, what a meanie. Okay. All right, so I just attack, right? I feel like he's not really being that, like, at least thus far, that uncordial. He's just kind of like, your deck doesn't look that good to me. Do you think it's good? Okay, that's fair. He did play. He did play pretty poorly this game. What do you need to delete? What he said? Or what you said? So this isn't the most popular daily of the day. So I guess I can just concede because no one's going to see this list anyways. How many tickets would that be? I should have just said yes to this. Three times six. Sure. Doing a good turn daily. Yeah, I won. I'm basically just doing a split. Sort of. It's not a split. It's not a split. It's me getting the winnings and giving him the QP. Because I don't care. I mean, I could just... He just asked for it, and I don't play enough. So someone might as well get some value. You know, it's just, like, whatever. Yeah, he just wants the QPs. It's really... If he's going to do something with it, it's going to be more than me. I just don't get to play enough. It's like, I get to do like one tournament a week, really. This was sweet because I could double queue. But... And he would give me my packs if I cared, but I think I'd rather just go to sleep than figure out the actual value of those packs. Because it's probably, he may have shorted me a ticket, but I'm not going to quabble. Six times three seems fine. Yeah. Oh, well, there you go. He rounded up for me. I kind of figured he wouldn't try to screw me on one meet, just like straight up helping him. I have no reason to do anything other than that. Wow, I honestly couldn't have done this without you, to be honest, Chris. I was just like, I'm fading hard, so. Oh, no. Oh, he's here. Okay. All right, well, I don't know how many viewers I have, but I think I'm going to head out for the night. Just make this last trade with this guy and then hit the hay because I got work tomorrow and I'm pretty fucking tired, so. If you want to play anymore. Yeah, well, I did lose the other one, but that one, yeah, I mean, the other one was like mono black, which is, you know, I don't think that's ever going to be winnable. And then, you know, you're going to lose to Affinity, especially when they have god draws like that guy had, so. So, yeah, I'm sure I'll be able to play more. And if you ever want to play with it, that's pretty good, actually. That's actually really good. Read exactly what that says. It is a little weak on its own. Huh. I'm going to consider that, because that's a really good one, actually. Another blue creature. If there's another blue permanent, oh my god, I'd be all over it. As it stands, I'm going to try it. I'm just going to straight up try it, because I am tired of these guys. They do nothing. How important is blocking, though? Like, because if we're doing this, why aren't we just doing, like, Welkin turn? Who's always going to have two power? I guess in the air, if we can cloud it, a 3-3 is a lot better than a 3-2. I'll try it. I think it's definitely worth a shot. It's a good idea. Doesn't stand alone very well, though. That's my one concern, because that's sort of like the thing with the Ephemerons, was it was like, okay, I have nothing else besides Ephemeron. I guarantee there's a creature that's going to fit this slot. Like, it'd just be amazing if there wasn't another creature of that is efficient. That's red or blue.
Interesting. Oh, he must have lost connection or something. Yeah, I know it can't block, but my thing with it is just like, are we ever blocking the Briarberry cohort? Like, maybe we chump with it at some point in time, but it's like the last thing we want to do, right? What does this guy do? Target creature gets plus 2, plus 0. That's an interesting card. Wow. My friend just said he won PTQ Vienna. He's a pro, so I'm not surprised, but he can qualify for the Pro Tour. Wow, Moto, come on now. Okay, so it's just going to crash on me. Should really go to bed, but I need to talk to this guy for a while. I'm still pretty bummed we didn't win the mono blue matchup. Just feel like I messed something up. That's like the number one matchup where I wish I had Jataxian Probe. Because just knowing what to play around would just... Like, that is the hardest part about playing against them. Because they don't really have very much that they can do. I'm going to peep through these options one more time, too. Just because this cohort has got me thinking. Yeah, and Welkin turns kind of weak in the fact that it just dies to like all of the fairies. Shadow. I thought about Spiketail Hatchling. I tried him. It's interesting, but it's not as good as I thought it would be. Tropolis sprite is interesting. Flutterill Core. Yeah, that's pretty good. I don't know why I typed that, I could have just said it, but theoretically with looting that's never a bad thing, because you're always just like maximizing the cards in your hand. Sometimes it's like mildly awkward, but shouldn't matter, because one of the cards is going to be less optimal than the others. So I don't think that's really that big of a deal. We should maybe consider Jilt as a sideboard option. I just had one too. We should write these all down. Yeah, one damage is not enough. Oh, Metropolis Sprite. This one's actually pretty interesting because it can beat like Barbary Cohort if we wanted to. But we can also cloud it. Jilt's pretty sick, actually. You probably really like it. Like, it's just a really good card. So it says, return target creature to its owner's hand. If Jilt was kicked, so it's blue and a colorless, and kicker is red and a colorless. If it was kicked, it deals two damage to another target creature. So it's like a two for one for four. Or just unsummon for two. obviously not optimal, but against like Stompy or maybe even like Affinity. It's a really good card. It's just like the only reason why I haven't tested it is because 4 mana is a lot of mana for our deck, but we've been flooding out. Yeah, it is a lot like Far and Away. I would definitely consider running this over the withdraw. Not that I'm even running it, but. So I think I'm going to go to sleep because I really need to. But Lutero Killer, Metropolis Sprite, Briarberry Cohorts, even just Merfolk Looter. No, we need something that beats. But these are all options. I'm surprised we can't come up with anything in red. So the pinger also, the little goblin pinger, I think is worthy of a shot. He obviously doesn't beat very well, but pinging has value. Yeah, it's kind of a bummer how bad red is. That's true. I didn't even think about that. Yeah, so red really isn't even an option because the best aspect of that card is negated. So did I go on the day? 4-3? That's not very good. I guess Goblin Electromancer is still an option. This card is pretty cool. I think 3 mana is the max, and I'll look through this, and then if I don't see anything, I'm just going to go to sleep. Yeah, I agree. It doesn't end in mana leak. I do think that's somewhat valuable, though. Like, I do often, part of why I don't like Stone Rain that much is not because I can't cast it. It's because I can't cast it and leave up extra mana for something else. Silkbind Fairy is pretty good. Consideration. We could play this, possibly. Spinethopter. It's like... it's like Welcome Turn that can block for 2 life. Of any color, too. So if we... I tried Riverfall Mimic Quick right at the start, and I decided there's just not enough dual color cards. It's sweet, like when you the first time you clout, but then you just have like a pretty good sized guy, that, but he's not like great sized. I don't know. Like the 3/6 body on the weird is like so good, but a 4/3 isn't that good. Use. one, two unblockable target creature now. Two, three. I thought about these guys too. Just like perm basically spheres of resistance. This could be okay. Maybe not, though. Yeah, I agree. That's exactly what I thought in my head. I was like, no, I'm just being too cute. I thought about this guy, Frost Raptor. Switch our lands to all snow lands. This guy's okay, he's value. Yeah, 3 mana, I feel like, is stretching it. I think Pestermite's decent, too, but yeah, again, 3 mana. Man, I wish I really understood what Phazing did, because this guy seems like he could be okay. I know your auras stay on him once they leave. In fact, this could be pretty sick. I don't, in the meta, like, if this does what I think it does, which is probably not what it does, it gets around, like, Flame Slash, just dominates the air. But I don't think it works the way I think it does. I'm going to consider it, though. Well, yeah, but Galvblast is, like, the one does it too, and I think every one of our options is going to die to Gale's Blast. Is it always during your end step though? Like, is that like how it works every single turn? Leaves at your end step, comes back at your upkeep with haste. So it's sort of like the Welkin turn, it'll never block. It's interesting. Never blocking is also like simultaneously not the worst thing. Noggle Bandit. Basically 2/2 unblockable. Turns into a 4/4 if you cloud it. I think that's everything. You know, I wouldn't actually be against the Wii Dragonauts as opposed to the other options. This actually like has evasion. The other ones, they just, like, get chomped. In our deck, I think he's way better than the Cyclops or the Fiend. And then Calcite Snapper was like the last thing I was considering too. Stormbound Geist is okay. Streamhoppers, I just don't think... If we're going to go the Streamhopper route, I think we need to go also the unblockable guy route. I just feel like without Clout, it's terrible. Like, it is a good turn one play. You can Clout it, then you just have like, it's basically like build your own Delver. But without that, it's just kind of meh. Yeah, that's too much mana. So I think I like these options. I think I might like Metropolis Sprite more than the Cohort, because the Cohort's better in the situation that I don't care about. Like, if we already have a Delver beating face, I don't care if we have the Ephemeron in play or not, really. Like, we're probably fine. But I feel like Metropolis Sprite can beat as much face. It's better than Welcome Turn because it blocks and it's not an X1. And then it gets a little bit better if you Clout it. So I think that's just better than Welcome Turn and Bribery. And I think these guys are, well, I don't know why I have two, but I think this guy's just better than them too, because you can cast them off red mana if we have that issue. We don't have to pay life if we don't want to. Still Clout protected. And then this guy's just pretty good value. He might even be the best one. So, I think I'm going to go to sleep, but we got to remember these because I want to try them all. Yeah, I know we're always going to. I don't necessarily agree with that. Like, I can imagine a hand that's like, double raise, double mountain, Clout, and a bolt. And wait, double raise, double mountain, bolt, Clout, and then Spinethopter. Well, yeah, I mean, we can definitely try this first. I don't really consider this like a winning or losing situation. Oh, yeah? You think you would? Okay. I basically just tried to craft the best possible situation, but if you would mold the best possible situation, then I guess the color aspect of it doesn't matter. But I don't think that we need to, like, decide this immediately. In fact, I kind of want to test all of them. I just want to remember what they are. I'm actually just going to tweet it. And then if you come up with anything... Yeah, I need to go to sleep. Oh, all of our draws would be bad, you mean? Take it easy.